We are delighted to welcome Michael Bonner this year as our featured speaker for this event. Every day, he works hard to make a lasting impact on his students by abandoning the old model of education. Goodbye direct instruction and hello communal learning. Not too long ago, Michael was honored by Ellen DeGeneres, NBC Nightly News with Lester Holt, and the Ashton Kutcher Foundation. Now, as a fourth grade and sixth grade teacher at Ron Clark Academy, Michael continues to challenge the normal perception of the classroom, not only for his students, but for his colleagues. Due to the increased stress in the education field, he decided to utilize his platform for the common good. To combat this issue, Michael started the Michael Bonner Foundation, which has partnered with LEGO Education, 3M, Discovery Education, and PowerSchool to provide experiences that empower teachers all across the world. Please join me in welcoming Michael Bonner.
Check out this image right here. On the screen, what you see right now is all the companies that were created during 2007. You see Snapchat, you see a teacher's best friend, Pinterest. You see maps, which people may underestimate, but let's think about this. How many of you remember using MapQuest in the earlier? Yes. You print out the directions to your family member that can't read, and then you're lost for a 2-hour detour. You know exactly what I'm talking about, too. So on this particular point in time, what I'm showing you is we're in the prime moment to make something magical change. This isn't just rhetoric that I'm giving to you on today. We're at this prime, pristine opportunity to make something magical happen. What has happened is we believe that learning can only take place within the classroom, when in reality, you can learn from the dinner table. You can learn at the barbershop. You can learn from going to sleepover with your friend's house. You can learn from, nowadays, if we're honest, YouTube, right? So because of this piece, we have to begin to think about how can we advance education? How can we advance our thought process in this? You can't demand a withdrawal from somebody you have never invested in. You cannot. You cannot. I want you to understand on today, evolution is a part of the game. It's a part of the game. It's a part of life. When was the last time you've seen a Western Union? Right. When was the last time you went to a bank to actually transfer money? Right. With the gas prices going up to almost $5 right now, have you seen the influx of people buying electric cars? Evolution and evolving is a natural part of the game. I believe if you do not begin to evolve as leaders in education, which all of us are, we're going to end up phasing ourselves out of the classroom. Here's two questions I want you to think about, okay? First one says this, does the education system encourage creativity or suppress it? But the thing I want you to talk about at lunch today, especially if you go out later tonight and get you some mimosas that they have for $5 here at the Sheraton, right? I want you to discuss this one. Do you believe this is by accident or by design? NAF is about being future ready, about being innovative. There is something called the World Economic Forum. The entire world operates off of economics, which is pretty interesting because in school systems, we don't teach financial literacy, but we live in a capitalistic society. So with this particular piece, the entire world operates off of economics. Mr. Bonner, I don't think about that. I don't think that's true. You should see what they're trying to do to fix inflation right now, which is at a 40-year high, right? You should look at what the government is trying to do to fix that there. The World Economic Forum, the top 1% CEOs in the world meet together and they say, what kind of skills do we need in order to actually hire people? What are we looking for? Are we looking for an actual doctoral degree and those that are certified in different places? Or are we looking at certain skill sets? And as you begin to study this piece later on in the slides, what I want you to recognize is there are different things that our kids already do that we can amplify in our classroom that can make things better. We're at the point now where our kids are building their own solutions to the problems inside of the education system. I'm always grateful for the grace of God to be in the position to talk to educators and help you understand that we can do this. Why do I say that? Because I know what it feels like to want to give it all up, to be completely done with it. Now, if you're in that position or if you're charged up, whatever state of mind that you're in, I'm here to just confirm to you that now is the time to do something different. As you embrace disruptive innovation, to not back down, to stand firm, to stay elite, to make sure that what we're doing is going to change the life of our kids, because what we're doing is not just getting them to pass an assessment. What we're doing is creating generational wealth. Thank you so much for your time, and I appreciate you.